Greetings and salutations. In this episode of the Tim of Borg show, we're going to do Stormfell update stuff under the Terran Gambit season. The Calling episode, the next one on from the last two Janeway-focused episodes. Alright, so let's hail it.
There's been a breakthrough in our efforts to learn more about the Terran Empire's operations in the Mirror Universe. Our intelligence forces would like you to be a part of the plan going forward. Report to our intel agent on Jupiter Station. They'll have more details for you there.
Okie dokie. Looks cool. That's the rewards. Accept. Okay, I was in the right location for it. So we'll begin the mission now. Sorry for the delay with this. I did try to film this yesterday, but I had something happened. I had to start again today. Oh well. Yep, let's start now. One thing that sort of annoys me right away is that I'm being greeted by Burgess, and I was hoping and expecting to see Janeway in the mission. I thought the developers had said that Burgess was being replaced by Janeway. But that was just in some Delta Quadrant mission stuff, I guess. But I thought in general, just like, you know, wasn't Janeway going to become the number one Admiral contact? Or number two Admiral contact? Anyhow, sorry for ranting. Or rambling, I should say. Okay, here we go. Talk to Burgess.
Welcome to Jupiter Station. You'll pardon me if I dispense with the usual formalities, but the urgency of the situation demands it, I'm afraid.
Understood.
If you'll follow me, I can show you to the briefing room. Our partners in the operation are waiting for us there.
Very well. Lead the way.
The briefing room isn't far. Aelia regained consciousness recently. We have her isolated for observation at the moment. Ooh. Strangely, she's asked to speak with you. Quite urgently, I might add.
Okay, hello.
You've arrived. We can now begin.
Indeed. Who are you?
I am called Aelia. I am a part of Vidra. And speak on their behalf.
Some believe Aelia to be dead.
I am that which was Aelia, and more. Evolved, a part of Vidra.
What are you?
In simple terms, I am a cybernetic lifeform, a living machine programmed with the knowledge of what was once Aelia of Delta. As a part of Vidra, I am able to utilize their power and knowledge, though at a greatly limited scope. I am evolved.
Cool. Why are you here?
Vidra sensed the other, alike and yet different, a dark reflection. Where Vidra once wished to merge with their creator, the other wishes to punish their creator for abandoning them to the void.
What does that have to do with us, though?
Vidra believes the other is being sought by those you know as Terrans. They believe the Terran leader wants to use the other for his own purposes, including conquest. Vidra does not want this. I am here to help you prevent that from happening.
Are you? Okay, then. Cool. How did you get here?
Through Vidra. I am able to move over great distances. The greater the distance, the more energy it requires, and the greater effect it has on me. When I was with Vidra, we were very far from this universe. Traveling here came at great expense to me.
Oh, okay. What kind of expense? That's weird. So what is the Emperor's plan?
The Emperor knows that I am a part of Vidra. Connected. Somehow, he was able to redirect that connection to the other, The Terrans injured me. Instinctively, I called out to V'ger. Only my calls were not heard by them. It was the Other who heard me. And it wants to know more. It searches for me now.
So he used you as bait.
A crude term, but applicable. I believe the Emperor wanted to use my connection to lure the Other into a trap, but I do not know why.
What is your plan, then?
I will go to the Other. I will communicate with them, as I would with V'ger. I will try to reason with them, to soothe their rage, and prevent them from falling victim to the Terrans.
Okay, that sounds dangerous even for you.
The Other is powerful and angry. They may not listen. I can only hope that, in learning of V'ger, they realize they are no longer alone. They may find hope.
I hope so, for all our sakes.
Do you have any more questions?
No, that will be all. Ooh, wow, cool.
That was quite the feat. One hopes her trip to the Mirror Universe is not as taxing as her trip here, from wherever she was with V'ger.
Apparently, it was taxing. Agreed, indeed.
Well, I don't know about the rest of you, but I'm not big on placing my faith in one person. Even a bald demigoddess from another dimension. So, what are we gonna do while she goes off to confront the Other?
That's a good question.
Indeed. I'd like to begin with an intelligence briefing from one of our allies. They're a member of the Coalition, a resistance group in the Mirror Universe. Mr. Rayit, if you'd care to join us.
This should be interesting.
Thank you, Commander, all of you, for your time. You're going to want to hear this.
You have got to be kidding me. This guy? He's a glorified pirate.
Do restrain yourself, Admiral. Rayit has traveled a great distance at great risk to himself and his crew to deliver critical information on the enemy's activities. I'd ask you to respect that effort and hear what the man has to say.
Okay.
Thanks, Commander. Something big is going down on a planet called Pavo. Our Pavo, to be specific. We don't have a lot of time, so I'll get right to it if everyone's ready.
Okay, tell us what happened. Ooh, cutscene.
Most Terrans fear Pavo. They think it's cursed. Truth is, it's a curse of their own making. Years ago, they started brutalizing it, turned it into a monster. Then the monster turned on them. Needless to say, we were a little surprised when Tilly went to the Terrans' graveyard. Seems the Terrans got past their fear. And now? We have a new reason to fear them.
Welcome to Pavo, my own personal hell. Never thought I'd be in this wasteland again, but... When the Emperor says go to Pavo, I go to Pavo. Better than going to an agonizer booth on the maximum setting. Not by much, but better.
Wait, you've been here before and lived?
Indeed I have, Sunshine, several times. The first time was a long time ago. My enemies managed to get me assigned to this system. Got caught in an ion storm and wound up in that universe near the goody-goody version of Pavo.
That sounds lively.
Oh, it was. I had a pretty sweet scheme in place there before some of the locals threw a wrench in the works. Managed to get away using Pavo's power. And much to my surprise, I wound up here instead of Risa. And I really wanted to go to Risa.
What happened next?
Oh, you know, fought for my life, barely managing to survive, haunted by energy ghosts, business as usual on good old Pavo. Things were looking pretty bad, but one day, surprise, the Emperor sent some advanced scouts here as part of this big scheme of his, and they found me.
So you were rescued then?
Oh no, some of them immediately tried to kill me. Bad move. The ones who survived realized someone like me who figured out how to weaponize Pavo, that someone might be worth something to the Emperor. And here we are.
Right. Enough reminiscing. We have a job to do. Let's get to it, shall we?
Let's just do this quickly and get it over with. This place sucks. I almost wish it was lush again so I could burn it all back down.
Rise is overrated. Orion's the only place to party.
Okay, cool. Let's go this way then. Or not. I don't know. Which way are we supposed to go? That was lit up. Don't seem to be able to go that way. Find a Pavel crystal. Just going in the wrong direction. Whoops.
They're here! Open fire! Straight to kill!
How did those terrorists manage to find us here?
They're more resourceful than you think. Clearly.
Let's take a look.
Ready weapons and open fire!
Examine crystals. Examining. Inspecting.
Looks like these crystals are burned out.
Move out and watch for coalition forces.
Okay. Over here now. Lots of bad guys on the way. Come on, Tilly, Killy. I can't believe she destroyed Pavo.
Time for you to die, Imperial scum!
It is a good day to die, Terrans!
Ah, there's one. Looks like the forward team managed to get our gear hooked up before the Coalition Goon Squad got here. Better make sure it still works, though. One of those mouth breathers might have fiddled with it before we arrived.
I'll check it out. Activate Agonizer.
Nice. Looks like it's working as expected.
Oh my god, look. Killy stopped it from being a green paradise and burnt it down, because normally this planet is all beautiful like one of the most beautiful maps in the whole game.
See, the guys who tried this before me just started blasting the crystals with agonizers at full power. Didn't work out well, did it? But me, I took the finesse approach. I was patient. I modulated the agonizer settings based on the response from each individual crystal, and voila! Success!
Ah, well done. The Emperor picked the right person to lead our efforts here.
Your little helpers don't say much, do they?
No. They let their guns do their talking for them, unlike some people.
Oh yeah, pew pew pew, fascinating conversations. Deep. Very deep.
Over there. Come on then, gang. That's a bit disappointing that we're not using our normal away team at this point. Maybe we get to later in the mission. Am I going in the
right direction? It's Kelly! Shoot her! Shoot her now!
Oh, that nickname will never get old.
After nearly 2 centuries. Impressive.
Shoot, what was going on there?
Flanking damage detected.
Come on then. No time to waste.
Sounds like the advance team ran into the coalition punks. We'll need to tune the crystals ourselves.
Right, everyone stay sharp. Don't let them get the drop on us. Another orbital strike. His abilities don't take long to reset. Time out.
That's one squad down. Don't forget to activate the agonizer.
Jump. Okay. To be the agonizer. Ooh, look at that. Okay. More mirror guys to kill.
Two down. Get that agonizer operational.
Over here. Activate any agonizing inducer. Agony inducer. Ooh, poor thing. I wouldn't really be doing these things to it. This isn't me. This is the mirror me that I'm playing as. Clearly.
And that makes three. You know what to do.
Yes. I know what he would do, not what I would personally do. Clear on that, since this is a flashback or something.
All right, the agonizers are all 5x5. Let's make sure the central control system is still operational.
Okay, we're on it. Let's move out, squad.
Let's make this happen fast, Inquisitor. There's far too many coalition goons around here lately.
Goons. She's always funny with the words she uses. Where are they? I don't know. Oh, this thing, right, we've got to press the buttons. Activating console.
Okay, we're almost ready to go here. I need to calibrate the transmission settings, and then we should be able to send the Emperor's message out to deep space. Watch my back. We've come too far to fail now, and you know the price of failure in the Terran Empire.
No, failure is not an option for us. You do your job, we'll do ours. Alright, it is me in disguise, that's why I've got a voice box. I think I actually get to meet the mirror me next. I did try to play through this mission before, but I didn't complete it.
I'd ask you to surrender, but we all know that's not in the Terran vocabulary.
Oh, come on, is the entire coalition on Bravo today?
Another skull from the trophy hall.
I'm okay. All good. Just a flesh wound. Keep fighting! Take him down! Fire at will!
Must be something over there.
How does it feel, being a Terran lapdog?
Yeah, it doesn't feel too good, hurting nature. Don't like that.
Hope your affairs are in order, Terrans. How does it feel, being a Terran lapdog? Hope your affairs are in order, Terrans.
Hey, stop running around so much. I ordered an orbital strike round. Stay where you're supposed to be to receive it. Man, you still got plenty of life. Hurry up and die, you. There you go. I got him. Oh, that's cool acting.
It's me. Get us off this hellhole, right now!
Animation.
There you have it. Pavo was dangerous enough before, but now, I don't want to think about what the Terrans can do with its power. Something needs to be done. Fast. Based on the data we were able to collect before we had to withdraw, it looks like the Terrans are going to use the antenna on Pavo to send a signal into deep space. Somewhere.
Yeah, see, that was weird, because it was like a flashback. But then I had to play it instead of just watching. Anyway. Which was like the other episode, Redshift, where have to play as Mirror Thing, and I had a voice box with that voice. So it's a bit confusing. I'm confused. I don't know. Maybe I'm just simple. Too early in the morning for me. Not enough coffee, because I don't know. Anyway, sorry. Most likely to the other that Ilea spoke of.
There's more. They set up tech to weaponize Pavo. That antenna will turn into a planetary-based cannon of unimaginable power if we don't stop the Terrans. Something that strong might be able to hurt anything, even this other you're talking about. And it'll definitely make short work of any Coalition ship in its sights. Even a dreadnought.
I wonder who the other is. That's the big surprise, maybe for the next episode's mission update. I'm going to take a guess, because there's one thing we haven't seen. I was thinking about what the developers were saying in a recent video, that they're going to have lots of most of the voice acting is going to be from women or something. Most of the Star Trek actors they're trying to get at the moment are all women, and they're like proud of that or something, you know. Like they put a video on their channel about that, with that topic name. Anyway, and I thought maybe it's going to be 7 of 9 from the Mirror Universe, like Jerry Halliwell, you know, like, I mean, Annika Hansen, you know, character, Mirror. We haven't seen the normal Mirror Universe version of her yet, have we? I mean, we saw a different alternate timeline, one in Picard, where, and also because Janeway got assimilated in the Delta Quadrant and has the same implants as 7 of 9 used to have, you would have to assume 7 of 9 is not a liberated Borg in the Mirror Universe. But if she is a Borg, maybe she's the Borg Queen, and maybe she's the other, and maybe the Borg and V'ger have this connection that people, fans, have always been talking about for years. So it could go down that road, or it could be somebody else, who knows. Anyway, sorry. Or any vessel in the Alliance fleet, for that matter. Well, except mine, of course, because, you know, I've got the best ship out there.
I think we understand each other here. I know I'm a glorified pirate, but I'm willing to risk it all to stop these bastards. Are you?
Yeah, for sure, man, because I can always just respawn. Anyway, I am. We are. We will do what needs to be done to stop the Terrans.
Well, I'll say this for the pirate. He can make a convincing speech when he wants to.
Indeed, indeed.
Yeah, enough about him. We need to get moving. You ready to go?
Mm-hmm. Beam me up, leader. Let's beam up, leader. Engage. Energized. Cutscene. Pavo system. Ooh, there's my beautiful ship.
We made it. Good timing. The Coalition's taking a beating here, particularly from the Terran flagship.
Yes, the ISS Enterprise. It's another Enterprise.
Aw, nice of Tilly to bring my ship out to this hellhole of a planet. If there's even one scratch on my ship's hull, one micrometeorite dent... Well, you know the rest. Murder,
Coalition death, forces, you know, this is Rayeet. The new arrivals are allies. Please don't shoot them.
Let's hope the other pirates listen to their fearless leader.
Now the prodigal daughter returns. Ready for another thrashing?
Whoa! Tilly left Kumarke in command? This day gets better by the minute.
Sorry about that. I shouldn't have started engaging, but my... hangar pets made it start. I haven't pressed fire, so they shouldn't be fighting. Started the battle and then they started talking over itself, and I could hardly hear anything the leader said. But if I close this, will it redo it? I don't know. I don't think it does. I'll try. Give me that dialogue again. Come on. Oh. Fight the Terran fleet.
Target energy spike on the surface of Pavo. Brace for impact!
Nice shields and ship test. Enterprise, if.
Oh my. If only your ships had modified shields like Enterprise. Captain Tilly really is a genius.
Look, that blast from Pavo disabled us, but we're not done yet. I can use my command drone to use their transporters to beam a boarding party over to the Enterprise.
Okay, I'll just go along with that, even though we know my shields didn't really get hurt. I clearly have the best shields too. Oh. Tilly's, universal shields, whatever. upgraded to max. Surely they've changed your command codes by now.
The command codes they know about, yeah. Fortunately for us, I have a backup set of codes, and they damn sure don't know about them.
I hope you're right.
Take me with you. You need all the guns you can get over there.
Okie dokie. Later?
Ugh, I have my doubts about this, but I suppose having some cannon fodder wouldn't hurt. Fine, the pirate can come too. Just stay out of my way and don't touch anything. Everyone ready to beam over?
Okay. Beam me over. Sure. Looks like an okay away team to me. Energize. Loading Mirror Enterprise app.
And we made it. With all of our atoms and such in the right place.
At least I got my normal array team now with all their special powers. That trick will only work once. Now what?
We need to take control of the ship. And, you know, if Kumarke, Killy, or the Inquisitor are forced to shuffle off this mortal coil, even better. And, bonus points for all three, of course.
Stay focused. We can't stop them if we don't have a functional ship.
Helping Leda out with her personal vendettas is not what I'm here for. Settle your old grudges on your own time.
Okay.
Aww, it's cute that you think you're in charge, pirate. No, I take that back. It's really annoying. Keep quiet while the grown-ups are talking. Now, let's take back my ship.
How do you intend to do that?
We're near engineering. Let's go there, disable security, take control of the turbolifts, and head to the bridge. It's high time I had a little chat with that treacherous purple hobgoblin after all. Time sitting in my chair is about to come to an end.
Right. All right, let's get moving. Ready weapons.
I meant what I said about your vendettas, Leda.
Oh, and here I thought a pirate thug like you would want to kill Terrans.
Security of the bridge! The traitor and her lackeys have arrived!
Going the right way? I don't know. Do I have to go through this door? Okay.
Defend engineering or die trying for the Empire!
All right. See that engineering alcove? Use the console there to disable the security doors and fields. Pirate, you're on turbolift controls. We need control of those fast.
And what will you be doing?
There's something very dear to me that I need to check on. It won't take long. That's it. That's the plan. Let's make it happen.
Okay, very well. Work fast, everyone.
I don't like this. Or her. She can't be trusted.
The feeling's mutual, pirate. Do your job and this'll all be over soon.
Working. Beep, 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 beep.
How very clever of you. It'll take a while to restore control over the security systems. Whatever shall I do to pass the time?
I'm sure you'll think of something. Or is she the other? I don't know. I'm confused.
How right you are. I believe I have just the thing to amuse myself. Be seeing you.
Haha, okay. I do not like the sound of that.
Neither do I, especially since she's loading shuttles with proto-matter bombs in the hangar bay. Knowing her, I fully expect she'll order those shuttles to target your ships. And, well, at least they'll die quickly.
You really underestimate my ship. It's pretty much as powerful as, like, 10 of your ships. Kill your ships in 10 seconds. Anyhow, that's not gonna happen. We're gonna stop them.
Look, I get it, but every minute we spend not taking the bridge means that... Oh, never mind. You're not budging on this, are you?
Not at all.
Fine. Let's get this over with.
Let's get to the hangar before it's too late. What are we shooting at? What are you shooting at? Are we supposed to go through here? Turbo lift to shuttle bay. Bad guys.
Don't let them get past us!
I don't trust Lita to deal with these bombs. I'll handle them. But I need you to cover me while I work, okay?
We've got your back, bro.
Check your fire. Do not shoot the proto-matter bomb.
Behind us! These bombs are disabled. Moving on to the next set.
Okay. Follow him.
Taking fire over here. Another set done. Heading to the ones behind that runabout. On the upper level!
Upper level? Sorry. I'm not in the right place, am I? I didn't want that ship. Okay. Should I jump up here, maybe? Okay, I'm getting shot at. Wait, you. Oh, I'm about to die.
Thank you. That's the last one. I think we're done here.
Groovy. Speak with Leda next. Where are you, Leda? Come on.
There. No more proto-matter bombs. Now let's do what we came here for and take back my ship.
Very well. Let's make our way to the bridge. Back door, I think. Yep. Bad guys.
You're fools if you think you can win here.
If I had a strip of latinum for every time I'd heard that, I could buy a small moon.
Is that lag? What's going on? See, I told you I get lag.
You're what? Quite the persistent little swarm of gnats, aren't you?
Stand down, Captain. We won't ask again.
How very polite of you. Since we're still being civil, let me speak plainly. You will not take command of this vessel, and should you try, you'll learn a very painful and fatal lesson. Do I make myself clear?
Crystal. The console we need to lower the field is at the back of the bridge. Once it's down, you're finished. Why would I tell her that? See, maybe I would not tell her that. Just say, oh, okay. And then somebody else should tell me that, or I should know that already, or something. I don't know. Just play with my trivial. That'll make everything better.
There! The console in the back!
We'll cover you. Get that force field down.
Shutting down.
Get away from that console.
You need to try to stop me. Beep beep beep.
Allow me to introduce my name, Todd. Proto-matter powered attack drone.
Kumarke's inner force field is still up.
Hold the isolinear
chip
to disable her command console.
Right, come on.
They're in the panel, in front of the helm.
Okay. Nice. Come on. Hello. We're a bit close, aren't we?
Don't fret. I have plenty of troopers and drones to keep you entertained.
Oh, look at that isolinear chip stuff. Shutting down force fields. They're very LED-like. RGB lights.
I suppose I'll need to put my hands to the door after all. What a good news!
Karen remains
protein. We have to take out our drones first, don't we?
Oh, got it in one, pirate.
Defense drone.
Kumarke's drones are down. She's vulnerable now.
Where is she?
Oh, great. More of those damn drones. The drones are down. Let's finish this.
Damn it. She has drones again. The drones are down again. Take Kumarke out.
Oh, no, dear Leta. Oh, no, no, no. If I can't have the prize, no one. Computer, activate auto-destruct sequence. Authorization, Kumarke 00.
We both could have had the prize. We could have had it all, but no. You wanted it all for yourself. Stabbed me in the back for the favor of a madman. Now you've paid the price for your betrayal. Hope it was worth it. Hello, old girl. I'm back. Computer, open a shipwide channel.
Okay.
Attention, all hands. This is Admiral Leeta. Kumarke is dead. I am assuming command of this vessel effective immediately. If you disagree, feel free to step out of the nearest airlock and spare me the trouble of hunting you down. I have better things to do. Leeta, out.
Have your ship back, Leeta. But there's more to be done.
Damn right there is. I need to settle the score with the annoying Ginger who had the nerve to call this her ship.
Hold that thought. We're picking up a strange energy reading on sensors.
I made it.
I made it, Ilea has said. Okay. Oh, she's over there. Hello. Ooh. Beep. Speak with Ilea.
It's too late. I did what I could, but I failed. The other is coming. Here. Now.
That's not all. There's a Terran fleet approaching at high warp. See ya.
My place is here. In this chair. You need to get back to yours. Ready to beam back to your ship?
Beam. Might as well then. Okay, see ya later, alligator. Beam me back. Energizing.
Damn, it feels good to sit in this chair again. Real good.
Focus.
Just can't let me have my moment of zen, can you? Fine. Let's deal with the Terran ship so that we can get down to Pavo and deal with our Tilly still breathing problem.
Okay. Be advised, there are more Terran vessels approaching. This may not be a fight we can win.
You have got a lot to answer for, Leeta. And I am going to make sure you pay for what you've done. Bring it, Sunshine. You and I have a lot of unfinished.
Terrans killing Terrans. In the end, you all have a knife ready for everyone else's back.
That's how it goes, pirate. The good die young and the vile live long and prosper.
I'm detecting an energy surge within the entity. Reading, 12th power energy.
So, the Emperor's true prize is revealed at last.
Pretty ship. Ooh, it's Vija. From the motion picture. That looks cool. The movie. Ooh. Oh, look at those energy balls. Oh, no. I don't think it got my shit back, so it's okay. Oh, it's like they assimilated them or something. Oh, I don't know.
Looks like your ticket home just got cancelled. And more enemy ships are heading our way.
Okay. I don't suppose you have any good news then, do you?
Not really, no. I suggest taking out those plasma energy bolts the other is firing, while we deal with the enemy fleet.
Okay, don't give me orders, but understood.
Focus on the plasma bolts. Let us worry about the terrorists.
Can't take another hit like that.
You can't.
Yes! Scrapped one plasma ball. Nice shooting. Keep it up.
Lucky. Some sort of time travel shenanigans. Nearly died. I think it's my traits. Temporal operative? Yes, I'm a temporal operative. Some good permissions.
Focus on the plasma bolts. Let us worry about the Terrans.
Why am I not present? Come on, stop lagging. Kind of annoying. Oh, someone's got a tractor beam on me. I hate it. Oh, that. Why is it lagging so much?
You will be remembered, my friend. Always. Can't take another hit like that.
Who can't? What? Ooh, Laura, they just keep respawning. Warping in somewhere.
Stop those plasma balls. We just lost a ship.
Up a new volley of torpedoes, and that Terran fleet is about to arrive.
I think we need to wait for my buttons to recharge. It's kind of how everything is timed out, but I can't wait for 4 minutes. Understood. We'll be ready. The Avengers will be ready. Team of Borg out. Admiral Alita. Wasting time. Okay.
Just a few ships left to deal with. Okay,
The other is recharging. Give us a hand with the Terrans.
No. The Archeron. Cool. So it's a big ship.
That's the Emperor's ship. Look, if this is our last stand, let's do what we can to take that lunatic out, okay? Maybe that's the solution to the situation with the other we've been looking for.
The Acheron's shields are too strong. Our weapons have no effect.
Really? I find that hard to believe. Maybe I should cloak for a while. Perhaps, but for now, let's focus on surviving here, shall we? Surviving. Well, better just to go to the toilet for a minute and do some Admiralty assignments. Sorry to waste time. Okay, perhaps, but for now, let's focus on surviving here, shall we? Universe, back home. Lovely. I guess we'll have to fight the Archer on another day.
I'm guessing you have a few questions.
Yeah, indeed. We thought we were gonna be dead. Oh man, I was like, you know, trying to pick up all the kinds of healing stuff.
Well, the Terrans did their best, but it wasn't good enough. We were able to get away under cloak. But the portal tech was badly damaged. We started to conduct repairs, but that was slow going in hostile territory. Thankfully, we made contact with the Coalition.
ISS Enterprise. What happened next?
While we worked to get the components we needed to go home, we teamed up with Coalition forces to gather intel on Terran activities, especially those regarding Project Pharaoh. When we got wind of what was going on at Pavo, I was able to get a message through to Starfleet Intelligence. They asked me to remain and observe the Terran fleet movements while Ray Yeet delivered the intel report.
Oh, okay. And fortunately for us, you were able to complete your repairs?
Indeed. Would have liked a better outcome over Pavo, but we're still alive, able to fight another day.
Rightio, yes, agreed.
Let's go over all this on Enterprise. We might not have a lot of time before things get dangerous again.
Oh, you want me to come and talk to you in person again? All right, then, fine. Beam me over, energizing. That's the energized noise. Transporter. Signal lost. Oh, look at all these people. Hello, everybody. We must now speak to them all. Hello, Commander DeSoto.
I understand the concern over me being dead, but sometimes that can be a big advantage, especially in the spy game.
Yes, agreed.
Of course, the Terrans know I'm alive now as well. That'll make work on the other side of the mirror difficult in the future. But breaking cover and rescuing you seemed like the right thing to do.
Oh, nice. Cool. I'm grateful. We're grateful for your assistance at Pavo, of course.
Don't mention it. By the look of things, there's a lot of dangerous work ahead. And we're gonna need all hands on deck.
Yes, all hands indeed. Indeed, indeed. Thank you, Commander. Blondie. Nice hair. Okay. Oh, hello, Admiral Leto. Can I sit next to you? No, okay.
Enterprise is mine again. I expect I'll have to deal with a few would-be captains and their attempts to end me. But that comes with the center chair on a Terran ship.
So it seems.
Too bad Ilea wasn't able to talk some sense into the other. Not sure I like leaving it in the hands of the Emperor and his lackeys. Especially Killy.
We'll do what we must to stop them. You can count on it. Hello, not Admiral Janeway.
The situation at Pavo is cause for great concern, to be certain. Tactical planners from the Alliance are working on our next steps as we speak.
The Alliance. The Federation, but you've got people who are not part of the Federation in some alliance, so we're calling it that now, are we? Anyway, moving on. I suspect they will need to work quickly, Commander.
Indeed. Fortunately, we have the data collected by DeSoto and the Coalition in the Mirror Universe. The path to success may lie within that.
Keep me posted, Commander. I want to be part of the next operation when it happens. Hi, Ilea.
The other is conflicted, angry. No amount of reason would persuade them to stop, to be peaceful. They want revenge on their creator above all else. They believe the Terran Emperor can make that happen.
Interesting. And that's why the other went to Pavo, despite the obvious threats?
Yes. The other will stop at nothing to get what they want. In that way, they are very much like the Emperor.
Okay, any ideas of what we should do next, or who the other is?
We must stop the Emperor. I believe we can still connect with the other and convince them to seek a peaceful resolution to this conflict. We may need to make direct contact at the core of the other, as the crew of Enterprise once did with V'ger. That type of contact may succeed where I failed.
That could be difficult, Ilea, but if it must be done, we will find a way. Hello.
Can't say I'm thrilled to see Leda in command of one of the most dangerous starships in existence, but these things happen on our side of the mirror.
Unfortunately so, as it seems.
The Coalition could do a lot of good with a ship like that. But we'll keep up the good fight with what we have, when we can.
You're doing good work over there. It's appreciated.
Thanks. And speaking of that good work, I'll be getting back to it shortly. We'll keep an eye on what the Empire does at Pavo. When we have new intel, we'll get it your way.
Thanks you for that. Good luck out there somewhere.
Looks like things are wrapping up here. I don't think it'll be long before we meet again and get convinced to do something outrageous and dangerous. Ready to return to your ship?
Yep. Ready to return. See you later. God, I hope I don't see you again. Later.
Security bioscan complete. Access granted.
Computer, transport object 53 Sigma to my location. Hello, old friend.
Oh no, she's got one of those orbs again. The Koja Moja or whatever, Koja Mojin? Something? I don't know. That's what she talks about in that TFO, you know. Assault on Terignor. Coaster Major?
I've reviewed your report several times now, and it's still hard to believe what has happened. The Terran Emperor has summoned the Mirror Universe version of V'ger, and means to subjugate it somehow. To attempt such a thing is madness. And yet, the Emperor and his forces are out to do the impossible. What's worse, they may succeed. I've called for emergency meetings with our partners in the Alliance. We need a plan. When we have one, we'll be in touch.
Alright, okay then, thanks Quinn. Well, that was that. So it seems. What did we get? It's pretty annoying with all these things. Whoops, still left a dribble in my inventory. This is the reward. Some attack knife thing. Cool. Is that something that's like, is that a weapon that goes there or there? It's that type of weapon. Okay. Because I thought they also had something that was like this one here. Last episode was a knife that was actually a device slot, not a weapon. Which is cool, isn't it? Don't get many weapons in device slots normally. Alright, well, I'll give that episode a review number rating score system. Warp cores, I have a 10 warp core rating system. So I would say that's like a 7.69. Yeah, that's probably a good number. Because... Oh, I was really expecting to see Janeway again, hear her voice. So sick of Burgess, like, you know. I think the game was being a bit of a tight ass by not paying Kate Mulgrew enough money to do enough voice acting. And that's the only excuse for it. Well, it's very jarring that, you know, we've got this season with, you know, with Kate Mulgrew advertised in it as like the biggest star, so like her as, you know, at the front center of all this advertising. And then there's only two new missions that have her in it. I mean, I do know, and I have already played the Delta Recruit event again, and there are several, but it's only two more missions, maybe three, I don't know. Yeah, two missions where Janeway is being inserted into the tutorial. In the tutorial missions, the ones where you have to fight the Borg. So that's good, and there's some TFOs, but as far as I know, that's it for Janeway. Like, I don't know if she's going to be in the next mission because she wasn't in the current mission. And if it's just Leta and, you know, Tilly, kind of is disappointing for me as the giant Janeway fan. Then bringing Janeway back into the game was definitely what made me start playing daily again a few months ago. So it'd be disappointing if that's it for all the Kate Mulgrew content. And who is the other anyway? I guess that could be somebody famous, maybe. Who knows? Like, I guessed maybe it's Kate. Maybe it's you know. Seven of Nine, or maybe it's some other female actress from the Mirror Universe. I don't know. Anyway, yeah, it was a good mission overall, though. It's good that they gave us two missions, and we have this new event. It's Heart of the Storm, and you can get some pretty cool event rewards here with this ground set. That includes the drone module, so you can use that. And next I will probably be doing a video on the Forged in Fire TFO. That's a new one, which is a ground one. Yeah, so that's that. Okay. Look how I have one at the end of my campaign progress. Isn't that weird? Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed watching this video of the Team of Borg show, brought to you by Unimatrix 01 Productions and the Unimatrix 1 fleet. Please join my fleet if you want. Okay. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please support the channel. Till next time, live long and prosper. You'll be assimilated. Resistance is futile.